Hi everyone, and welcome to this week's Lowdown. The goal of the Lowdown is to pass along information to the membership at Hallberg Country Club in an effort to help them become better golfers. All the videos up until this point have been something technique driven, meaning that I've passed along tips or information to help you with your putting, your chipping, your pitching, knockdown, whatever the case may be. Well, this week we're going to take a little bit different path, and we'll try to do this about once a month, and that is we're going to talk about the rules of golf. The more knowledgeable I can make you about the rules of golf, the more knowledgeable I can make you about golf, the better golfer I can help you become. At Hallberg Country Club, we have a lateral hazard on 16 of our 18 holes. The only two holes that we don't have a lateral hazard on are 13 and 15. And if you think about it, if you hit the ball far enough left on those two holes, you can really say that there's a lateral hazard on both those holes as well. Here at Hallberg, a lot of our lateral hazards run to the alongside a hole, but also some meander right through the middle of the hole as well. So Hallberg, when we're talking about lateral hazards, provide you a lot of unique type of lateral hazards, and there's unique rules and situations of how to get out of those lateral hazards. A lateral hazard is any hazard that's marked by a red stake or line. It doesn't have to always have water in it, but anything that's really marked with a red stake or line. So what I've done this week is I've gotten five rules experts together, and they're going to help me explain to you, if you hit your ball into a lateral hazard, what all your options are, so that the next time you play Hallberg Country Club and hit your ball into a lateral hazard, you have information that can help you get out of the situation in the best possible way. Thank you. Take a look. Hi everyone, we're at number 18 here at Hallberg Country Club. We're about 140 yards away from the green. And this is a unique situation because on number 18, the creek and the lateral hazard actually kind of work right through the middle of the hole, okay? And being that's a unique situation, there's some different options that you can take to play this hole. I have Chase Thorpe here, one of our junior golfers, our junior club champion actually, here to help me out and show me one of the options to take relief from lateral hazard. And we're gonna pretend that Chase hit his second shot into the creek here. And Chase, let's say your ball comes and it's your second shot and you fly it right over that stake, and your ball goes in and lands, and you can find it, but it's in like 3 feet of water. How would you proceed?
Well, Liam, I find my ball, take my shoes and socks off, get in there, take a nice big vertical swing, and just whack it right out of there, because that's the type of player I am.
All right, so even though it's not a wise decision, necessarily, certainly one of our options is to go down into the hazard and hit the ball out, right?
Correct.
Do you have to take a penalty stroke if you do that?
No, just don't ground your club.
Just don't ground your club. Very good. Thanks, Chase.
Yep.
Hi everyone, we're on the back tee here on number 10 at Hallberg Country Club, and I'm with Emily Ryan, one of our four-hole junior golfers, and Emily's playing the back tee today, and she hit her first drive into the lateral hazard on the right side of the fairway. So Emily, what is one option that you would use to proceed to continue playing golf here?
I can re-hit the ball where I last hit it from.
Great, so you can just re-hit from the same spot you hit it from, right?
Mm-hmm.
All right, show us how to do it, Emily. Good shot, Emily. Very nice. Thank you, everybody. All right, we're here on number 9 at Hallberg. We're about 100 yards away from the green, and Eric Larson here has just hit his ball into the hazard off the tee box. Eric, what is one of your options that you can take relief from this hazard by?
I can take the point of the ball and where it went in, and I can go back as far as I want.
On that line. So you take that point where the ball went in, let's say it's right by that red stake, you can drop a line, keeping that point between you and the hole, you can go back as far as you want, right?
Yep.
10 yards, 20 yards, 30 yards, does it matter?
No.
All right, good answer, Eric. Hi everyone, again we're at number 18 here at Hallberg Country Club, about 140 yards away from the green, and this time I have Zach Tate helping me here. And Zach again is one of my more highly skilled junior golfers, and he wants to make sure that everyone knows that he would never actually hit a shot into the creek about at least at this point, or his second shot into the creek. So we're just pretending, Zach, let's just say you hit your second shot into the creek here, 140 yards away from the hole. What is one option that you can do to proceed and get yourself out of this trouble?
One option you can do is find where your ball, enter the hazard, and then drop two club links from that point of entry, no closer to the hole.
Very good. And do you have to take a penalty stroke?
Yes, you do.
How many?
One.
Great answer, Zach. I appreciate your help, bud.
Appreciate it.
Whatever, man. All right, we're here at Hallberg Country Club on the number 18th hole again, about 140 yards from the green. I'm here with Cole Crooker this time, one of my, again, highly skilled junior golfers, and we're just pretending that it is second shot into the creek. So, Cole, you hit your shot into the creek here at number 18, and it went right over this stake here, which is about 145 yards away from the pin. We took out a laser and measured it. Cole, how would you proceed here?
Well, Liam, I'd take advantage of the rules, and I would drop equidistant from where it entered on the other side, and I'd hit it from there.
Okay, so what you're saying is, and this is kind of where a lot of members don't know this rule, is you can go to the opposite margin of the hazard, okay, at a point equidistant. That means if it's 145 yards from right here, you find the point that's 145 yards on the other side of the hazard, and you drop your ball there, right?
Yes.
How far do you have to drop your ball, Cole?
Same distance.
Well, it's equidistant, but from once you find that equidistant point, how many club lengths do you have to drop the ball?
You drop it two club lengths.
Two club lengths, no closer to the hole.
No,
is that correct?
Yes.
All right. And that's probably the best option. Cole is obviously one of my smarter junior golfers because now he doesn't have to deal with that hazard anymore. Is that right, Cole?
Yes.
All right. Thanks for your help, buddy. Yeah. I appreciate it. Whatever. All right. I hope you enjoyed those videos. Like I said, we'll probably do something with rules maybe once every four videos, once every five videos, something like that. But anyway, we'll see you next week on the Lowdown. Thank you.